Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today we will discuss about exercise 11B of class 8 mathematics. You have already done question number 1, question number 2, and question number 3 complete. And today we will discuss about question number 4 of exercise 11B. Question number 4. We have done already what is Pythagoras' formula, what is Pythagoras' theorem, and what are the ratios for right angle triangle. We have already knowledge about what is a right angle triangle. A right angle triangle is one of the triangle whose one angle is 90 degrees. We have already knowledge that in any triangle, any triangle, all the angles, you have three angles, the sum of all the angles will always be 180 degrees. And also that, we have already knowledge that any triangle have three sides, any triangle have three vertices, any triangle have three angles. For right angle triangle, we have name of three sides. One side is base, other side is hypotenuse, and the remaining side is perpendicular. So the angle associated with perpendicular and base, that is 90 degrees. Or you can say that opposite to hypotenuse side, that is 90 degree angle. So 90 degree angle, the opposite side to 90 degree angle, that is hypotenuse. We have already knowledge about that. So if you are familiar with this, then we can continue this. Question number 4, part number 8. The diagram.
You
need to find the values of unknown in each of the following right angle triangles. This is basically the right angle triangle because you can see that the angle is this angle, this symbol is this square symbol angle is for 90 degrees. So basically it is a right angle triangle. Now you need to find the unknown values. The unknown value, that is, this is a centimeter and this is b centimeter. You need to find the value of a and also you need to find the value of b. Now you need to judge about the sides. The sides are basically this side and this side. The side opposite to 90 degrees, that is always hypotenuse. This is hypotenuse. That is 12 centimeters. And you are left with this side and also with this side. This is called the basic angle. This basic angle, we need to solve this question according to this basic angle. This basic angle, the side opposite to this basic angle, this is called perpendicular. Always we need to realize that the side opposite to the basic angle, other than 90 degree, this is not 90 degree, other than 90 degree, this angle, this is called the basic angle. The basic angle, the side opposite to it, which is always perpendicular. So this is perpendicular. And this is then base. So you need to find the value of perpendicular and you need to find the value of base. Now, the formula associated with these three sides is basically Pythagoras formula, but we can't apply here the Pythagoras formula because for Pythagoras formula, we need your requirement is two sides, two known sides. We have only one known side, that is this hypotenuse, 12 centimeters. This side is unknown, this side is also unknown. So we can't apply there Pythagoras formula. Now we have some ratios like sine theta, cos theta, and tan theta. Sine, cos, or tan. You can either apply it. You have sine of this angle. This angle is 34 degrees. Apply it. You are already familiar with some people have for sine. Some people have. P is for perpendicular, H is for hypotenuse. So this is basically perpendicular and this is hypotenuse. Some people have. This is basically the rhythm of these type of formulas. So perpendicular over hypotenuse, we can easily find any unknown side from these formulas. So after that, one thing you need to know about it, you need your scientific calculator, like what is the value of sine 34. Other than that, you can't find these values for your normal calculation, you can't get it. You need your scientific calculations. So you need to align with your scientific calculator. Sine 34 is equal to perpendicular. So find it, what is perpendicular here? Perpendicular is this, a centimeter. Sine 34 is equal to perpendicular here, that is a centimeter divided by, or simply you can write a here. In the answer, you can write your unit also. I'm applying a and hypotenuse value you have already. Hypotenuse value, that is 12 centimeter, you can easily find it. Now you can easily find the value of A. How you can find the value of A? This is 12, this will going to multiply with this sine 34. Now you need to find the value of sine 34. So you need your scientific calculator. If you don't have your scientific calculator, you can't get this value sine 34. So open your scientific calculator and apply sine 34, and you can easily get the value, that is 0.52 watts. Is equal to 8 divided by 12. Now you can, you need to multiply this 12 to 0.529. Okay. Open your calculator and now multiply 34 0.559, sorry, this value is 0.559. Now this 12 is going to multiply here 0.5591 multiply by 12, and after multiplication to this 12, we will get the answer, that is 6.71. A is equal to 6.71 and this unit is centimeter. And that's it. And now you are done with this side. A value, that is 6.71 centimeter. Now you are left with two sides which are known, that is first is hypotenuse and second is perpendicular, and still one side is unknown, that is base. Now you have the option, you can easily find the value of this base by applying Pythagoras formula. But this can be lengthy for some students. You have choice. You can apply Pythagoras formula after that. But if you want to solve this sine through any shortcut method, you can easily do this. You need to think about it, that which trigonometry ratio contains the base value. So we know that cos of this angle will have, some people have curly brown hair. So CBH, cos of this angle 34 is equal to, rhythm is brown, B means base, here, that is hypotenuse. Now you can apply here the values, The cos 34 value, what is cos 34 value? That is, open your calculator and find this value, cos 34, that is 0.829. 0.829 is equal to base value. We don't have any value base, so you can easily write it small b, and what is hypotenuse, that is 12. Now this 12 will bring to my beta 2. 0.829 multiply by this 12, that is 9.94 centimeter. And that's it. If any of the students need to apply, want to apply here, the Pythagoras formula you can easily apply and you will get answer really like this. But after point, the decimal part may be different. So that's not any problem. Now you have easily done with this question. The base value, that is 9.94 centimeter. And that's it. This was the first part of this question of exercise 11B. The part B is now another diagram is part B. That is, (90°C, D), (43°), (16°), and that's it. Now you need to find the unknown in this question. The unknown in this question is this side C centimeter and this side B centimeter. Now think about it. What is this side? Is this side base or this side is perpendicular? You can't judge it directly. Some of the students are possibly saying, for example, for this right angle triangle, this is right angle triangle because it contains a 90° symbol. Okay. So this is 90°. Obviously, opposite to this 90°, this is hypotenuse. But most of the students think this side is base because this is on the ground level and this side is perpendicular. This is not sure. This side can be base or this side can be perpendicular also. We can't surely say that this side is base. This side can be perpendicular. Or what about this side? This side is, most of the students will confirm me sure about this, that this side is perpendicular. This side is perpendicular. We can't say it, that this side is perpendicular. Either it can be base. How we can say that this side is base or this side is perpendicular? We need to judge about some angle, some basic angle. With that angle, we can easily judge that which side is base or which side is perpendicular. I have already told you that. Now, talking about this question, this is 90°. Opposite to this 90°, this side is hypotenuse. Okay. But if you are thinking that this side is base, then you are totally wrong. Because we need a basic angle. A basic angle is other than 90°. Other than 90°, that is this angle. This angle is basic angle. So I have already told you in the start of last question that opposite to that basic angle, this is basic angle, opposite to this basic angle, this side is called perpendicular. This is perpendicular. Always remember that. We can't say it surely that the side which is horizontal will always be perpendicular. Not sure. But according to this angle, this is perpendicular, and adjacent to this angle, other side, this is base. So we need to find the value of perpendicular and the value of base at the end. So for perpendicular, we have already knowledge about from previous question, sine of this basic angle, sine 43 is equal to perpendicular over hypotenuse. So what is the value of this sine 43? Calculate it from your calculator, scientific calculator. That is sine 43. That is 0.681. Is equal to perpendicular value. We don't have any perpendicular value, but D divided by hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is this 16. So 16 we are going to multiply with here. Now you can multiply this with 16. That is 10.911, or you can say 11 centimeter. 11 centimeter. This is the value of B here, 11 centimeters. Now you have two sides which are known and one side is unknown. So now you can easily apply the Pythagoras formula. If you don't want to apply the Pythagoras formula, you are left with base. So with base, you have cos. Cos is 43 angle, that is base divided by hypotenuse. Now, what is the value of cos 43? Calculate it from your calculator in your scientific calculator. Apply cos 43. That is 0.731. This is base C. And hypotenuse, that is 16. 16 we are going to multiply here. Yeah. So after multiplying it, multiply it with 16, that is 11.70. So C is equal to 11.70 centimeter. Always remember that within right angle triangle, the longer side will always be hypotenuse. This was your part number B. Now talking about your next part, that is part number C, that is this is 90 degree, this is E centimeter, this is F centimeter, this is 7 centimeter, and this is 44.2 degree. Now you need to solve it. For this right angle triangle, you can see that 90 degree is here. We need to judge about the sides. Opposite to 90 degree, this side is hypotenuse, which is unknown. And where is the basic angle? The basic angle is here, 44.2. Opposite to this angle, this side is perpendicular. So this is perpendicular. And the side adjacent to this angle, this is base. So you have only left with base. Now you need to find the value of hypotenuse. You need to think about the formula which contains the hypotenuse side. Sine theta, sine of angle, some people have perpendicular over hypotenuse. But we can't apply here sine because we don't have any value perpendicular and we don't have any value hypotenuse. So we can't find the value of hypotenuse through sine formula. Now talking about cos formula. Cos is base over hypotenuse. We have the value of base. Yes, we have the value of base, that is 7 cm. And cos of this basic angle, that is 44.2. Now you can easily find it. Cos 44.2. Open your calculator and find this value. Cos 44.2, that is 0.716. Base value, that is 7, and hypotenuse value is f. So you need to find the value of f. Now you need to find the value of f, that is here. So f will be there, and 0.716 will be the denominator. So f is equal to 7 divided by 0.716. Now divide them. 7 divided by 0.716, that is 9.77. And that's it. Now you are done with this value, that is 9.77. Now you are left with perpendicular. So for perpendicular, you have formula sine of basic angle 44.2 degree is equal to perpendicular over hypotenuse. Now the sine value, sine 44.2 that is 0.697. Hypotenuse is 9.77. Now easily you can apply multiplication of both of them. So E is equal to 0.697 multiplied by 9.77. So multiply it. This multiplied by 9.77. That is 6.811. And that's it. So now you are done with this perpendicular also. After this part, the last part is part D. I hope you can easily do this and solve this question. So this is your assignment. You can do this question. Now, if you have any question regarding today's lecture or any question regarding previous lecture, you can ask it now.